what we are going to start with? We are going to start with the Oracle functions. In Oracle, there is two types of function is there. Number one, we are having group function. Already you are familiar with group function or aggregate function. The group function or the aggregate function return one value for a group, and the second function we are having is it's a row function. The row function will return one value for a row. So in Oracle we are having the two types of function is here. One is group function. Group function is going to return one value for a group. Like I'm going to use select max of cell. From EMP. What we are getting? We are getting the maximum salary in the EMP table. So max is what? It's a group function. Because it works on the group and returns single value. Suppose I am going to use select min of salary from EMP. It's going to return the minimum value. Suppose I am going to use sum of salary. It's going to return sum of the value. So it works on the group and it will return the single value. That's what is called group function. So the first one is the group function. Now the next one we are having the row function. Row function means what? These function return one value for a row. Like I'm going to use select sysdate from EMP. See how many times we are getting the date. Sysdate is basically the function to return the current date. And how many times we are getting the current date?
Number of rows.
21 times. Why the 21 times? Because the EMP table having the 21 record. See, 21 record is there. Suppose I am going to apply the select sysdate from department. How many times we are getting the department and date? Yeah, it's 5 times we are getting the date. So as such there is no any use of just getting the same date 5 times or 20 times or 21 times. So what exactly we should require? We should require just to get the date and all only one time. So what we are looking for? We are looking for a table having the single record. That will be the better option. It's not like what is the use of displaying the date 5 times or 21 times. As such there is no any use of that. And why we are getting this? Because the table having the that much of record. So what now we are looking for? We are looking for a table with a single record. And Oracle is already there. We are having the dual table. The dual table contain a single record. So if I am going to run this command with the dual table, you will get the one values over there. Why we are getting only one values? But the dual is the table. It's a predefined table by the Oracle. If I am going to run select star from dual, see what we are getting over here. We are getting x. So dual is a table having the field called x, and this table is basically for the this purpose only, for this particular functions only, like the row function. So what I am trying to say, if I am going to apply the row function with the EMP table or department table multiple times, you are going to get the result. What I am expecting? I am just expecting result only one time. As such, there is no any use of display the result multiple times. So what we can do? Just we can use the dual table. So dual is basically what? It's a table. Remember, dual is table. It's a predefined table. It's a predefined table with single record. So dual is not a magic. Dual is simply a table. It's a predefined table with a single record, and with the row function we can use the dual to get the result only one time. Otherwise it will display the record result multiple times. That's it.
So it is an empty table with one
no,
record?
No, yeah, if it's an empty table, then what does it mean, the one record? It's basically, it's a table with one record.
And the record is empty, I can
guess. No. Record is there, that's why we are getting X.
Okay.
If I'm going to describe this dual, dual having the field called dummy.
Oh.
Yeah. Under the dummy, we are having the value X is there. So it's not an empty table. Only one record is there. That's it. So you need to remember, dual is not a magic. Dual is just a table with a single record.
Right.
And we can use the dual with the row function just to get the result only one time. And might be in the interview and all, someone can ask you the question, can you drop the dual table? Suppose I'm going to write dual table, drop table dual. See, we are getting the message, table of view does not exist. Remember, dual is the table and the owner of the dual is sys. So if I'm going to connect with the sys, connect slash as sysdba. If I'm going to connect with the sys and then I'm going to drop the table dual, it's working perfectly fine.
Oh.
Sys can drop the table because the owner of the dual was sys. It's not the escort. Escort having the permission to apply the select statement. That's it on the dual. Oh, I dropped the table dual. Do one thing. Create the table once again. Create table dual. And I'm going to give the name field like dummy. Is of type var char. 2 of 1. And I'm going to put the values over there. Insert into dual values. Suppose I'm going to put the values called X over there. And I'm just going to apply the commit. Now it's get created. So what I did, all these things, because that normally people think about the dual is, a kind of magic kind of table. It's not a magic table. It's a simple table. It's a normal table with a single record. That's it. The owner of the dual is the sys. The sys having all the permission regarding the dual. The sys user can drop the table, like sys can do anything. But if I'm going to connect with the escort tiger, escort don't have the permission. The other user don't have the permission for dropping the dual table. Other having only the permission to apply the select statement with the dual table. Select a star from dual. So if I'm going to apply the select, it's perfectly fine. If I'm going to apply the drop table dual, we are not going to drop that because we don't have the permission for this. And we are getting the message table of view does not exist. So this is what exactly the dual is. It's clear what is dual? Okay. Now, I'm going to start with a row function. In the row function, first of all, I'm going to start with the numeric function. Numeric function. Like, I'm going to apply select ABS of minus 90 from dual. This will return the absolute value. The absolute value for minus 90 is 90. Suppose I'm going to return select square root of 9. We are getting 3. Suppose, so these are the function. Suppose I'm going to apply power of 2, 2. We are going to get the 4. Suppose, so these are the function. Suppose I'm going to use select round of. I'm going to apply the round of 23.67. We are getting 24 because it's more than 0.5. Suppose this is 4.7, then we are getting 23 because we are applying the round. A round will always work for the 0.5. Suppose I'm going to give like comma 1, means what? It's going to round the 7 since 7 is more than 5. So the 4 get converted into 5. So the result will be 23.5. Yeah. Suppose I'm going to apply comma minus 1. Minus 1 means before the decimal. Before the decimal, 3 is there. It's less than 5. So it get converted into 0. So result will be 20. So this is the round function we are having. In the same way, we can apply the trunc function over there. Trunc function has nothing to do with 0.5. Whatever the value is there after the decimal, get removed. Whatever the value is there after the decimal, it's get removed. Suppose I'm going to apply trunc of comma 1. So 2 will get removed, so result will be 23.1. Suppose I'm going to apply comma minus 1. So the 3 will get removed and the result will be 20. So this is the trunc function. Suppose I'm going to apply select shell of ceiling, nearest highest integer. The nearest highest integer is 24. Suppose I'm going to apply floor, nearest lowest integer. Yeah, 23 is the nearest lowest integer. So these are what? These are the numeric function. It works on the number. Suppose I'm going to apply select sine of 23. It's a positive number, so it will return 1. Suppose I'm going to give sine of 89 minus 89. It's a negative number, so you will get minus 1. Suppose I'm going to return sine of 0. See, it's a negative number, that's why we are getting minus 1. It's a positive number, that's why we are getting 1. And it's a neutral number, that's why we are getting 0. So these are the different functions we can apply with Oracle and all. It's a row function, it's a numeric function. Now,
what does trunc do, sir? Trunc is doing basically truncating the after decimal part and giving the lowest number.
Yeah, exactly. Trunc has nothing to do with the 0.5. Round has to do with the 0.5. Now, the next is we are having the string function. A string function works on the string. Like I'm going to use select lower of. I'm just going to apply lower of from dual. You will get the result in the lowercase. If I'm going to apply this for the upper, it's going to convert it into the uppercase. Suppose I'm going to write for the init cap, initial letter get converted into the uppercase. Initial letter get converted into the uppercase. Yeah. The initial letter is going to convert into the uppercase. Suppose I'm going to apply select length of, it will return the length. Suppose I'm going to apply select substr of, suppose substring. Suppose I'm going to use this and that, and I'm going to put 2 comma 3. So it will return the 3 character from the second position. This is the second position and it's going to return the 3 character. So result will be HIS. Suppose I'm not going to give the number of characters. So it will return all the character from second position. Yeah. Suppose I'm going to use select INSTR of in a string. It's going to find out like whether this particular character is there or not. And what is the position of this? Yeah. I is available with the third position. Suppose I'm going to we have the multiple I. And this will give the first occurrence. If I want to get the last occurrence, what we can do? We can apply minus 1. It will return the result from the last. The occurrence of this I is at 11th position. Counting will always start from this side. It will give the position from the last because we are using minus 1. So this is INSTR. Suppose I am going to use a replace function. A replace. It's going to replace the I with what? Suppose I'm going to give XYZ. So it will replace I with XYZ. So we are having the replace function, INSTR function, substring function, upper function, lower function. Suppose I'm going to use LPAD. What I want to display? I want to display the salary. How many character you want to display? For the salary, I want to display the 10 character. And suppose the salary is 3000, then how it will get accommodated in the 10 character? Get padded with a star like this. And salary is the field available with the EMP, so I am writing EMP. See, we are getting the salary from the EMP table. And we are using LPAD. So in the left side, its padding is there. Suppose I am going to use RPAD, its right pad. The padding will be in the right side. This is how we can align the columns and all. We can use LPAD and RPAD. It's not necessary that a star. Even we can apply the hash, or we can apply any special symbol we can apply.
This what is the 10, sir? What is it doing?
Pardon?
What is the second thing 10 is doing?
10 is the number of character. Total character. Like 950, 3 character is there. Remaining 7 spaces are there. And the remaining 7 spaces get filled by the hash. And why the 7 spaces is there? Because you are using total character 10. Suppose I am going to give 5. Then, 950, remaining 5 means remaining 2 is going to be filled by hash.
Oh, I see. It's actually padding. I thought it's masking. Okay.
Yeah, it's basically masking. So these are these are the string function.
It's not masking, right? Because masking means hiding the values what we have, but it's not.
Basically, see, this is normally used for the alignment purpose. If I'm going to print something and I want to put some alignment kind of thing, for this we can use this. Okay. Like in the draft, in the check, normally the bank write the amount. After writing the amount, it's going to fill the spaces by the hash or the stars kind of something. This is for that. Now we are having the date function. Like I am going to use SelectSysDate from dual. We are getting the system date. I want to get the date after 5 days. After 5 days, what will be the date? It will be the 6th April. Oh, before 5 days, I want to see what was the date. I want to see the last day of the month. Last underscore day of. This date, 30th April will be the last day of the month. Suppose I am going to use next underscore day. I want to find out what will be the next day, what will be the date on Friday. So on the Friday it will be 3rd April. Suppose I want to get the date month underscore between. Like sys date, and suppose someone having the birthday on 2009. I want to get the month. It's total 132 months is there in between the two date, and I want to get the year. I'm just going to divide by 12 as year. So we are getting the year like this. It's 11 year. Suppose I want to see when we are going to apply sysdate, we are getting the date like this in this particular format. I want to change the format. How we can do that? We are just going to apply the toCar function is here. toCar of sysdate, comma dd /mm/y. This is the format you can apply. By default, this was the date, Now we are getting the date in this format. Even you can change this to cat offset date comma DDSP spell out 1 SPTH first. I am going to give the month 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 1st April. I am going to give the year like this. So we are getting 1st April 2020. So these are the different date format that we can apply. Suppose I am just going to give like single day, it's day of the month, sorry, day of the week, single day. If I am going to apply double day, day of the month, and if I am going to apply the triple day, day of the year, it's 92 day of the year. So we are having the single D, double D and triple D. These are the different date format. I want to display the time. We can apply, I want to display the time. HH colon MI colon SS, hour, minute, second. I want to also display the AM and PM. I am just going to apply the AM. Yeah, we are getting AM. Suppose I am going to write, like I want to display the date in 24 hour format. Right now,
why didn't you 092 when we use triple D?
Yeah, it's the day of the year.
Day of the year, okay.
Yeah. Suppose I want to display the date and time both. DD slash MM slash YY. Yeah, we are getting the date as well as we are getting the time. Suppose I want to see the date in the Julian format. Julian date. Like I want to see, like, yeah, this is the day from the Julian, beginning of the Julian day. This is the day from the beginning of the Julian day. So J is the format. Like I am going to apply and I want to spell out, like we can use SP for spell out. 2,458,941. Now there is a good question. Like we are having the salary. What I want to do, I want to display the salary in the words. Like I want to display the salary like this, 800, like this. How to do that? To display the salary in the words, what we can do, we can use sal, and we need to convert the sal into the date for date. So how we can do that? I'm just going to apply to underscore date of sal and going to convert into the J Julian date. And now we are having this particular date. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to convert this into the spell out from EMP. This is the interview question, how we can display the salary like this.
Sir, can you explain it again? Why did we use date here?
My question was, you need to display the salary like this.
Right.
900, 3000, 1300, 9292. This is the format I need to display. So what options we are having? In Oracle, only options is there, like we are having the Julian day. In the Julian day, we are getting the date like this. It's the date format. What I am going to do, I am just going to spell out. So, even the Julian day is there, for this Julian day, if I am going to spell out, we are getting the result like this. So now what I am looking for, I am just looking for my salary is there. If I am going to convert the salary into the date, So how we can convert this value into the date? So what I'm going to do, if I'm going to put the salary over there, so you cannot convert the from EMP, you cannot convert the salary to the date. We are getting the error in valid number format. So what I need to do, I need to convert this salary into the date. So this is how we can do that, because it's a numeric field. So I'm just going to convert the number into the date, and this is the numeric format. Now this date I'm going to pass to the toCAR. In the toCAR, I'm just going to apply the JSP, and we are getting the, even SP is not required over there. Yeah, we are getting this. So this is the interview question. For this question, you need to be ready for that. What we need to do, we just need to convert the salary into the date, and I'm also going to give the format, like I'm just going to consider it as a Julian date, like J. And
what is Julian date?
For that, do one thing. Like we are having the date format like AD, after death, BC, before Christ. The same thing, we are having the Julian day is also there.
Oh, I see. Okay, it's another way.
Yeah. So this is the Julian day, like.
Okay.
So my concern was just to display the salary like this. And for this, you need to convert the date into the Julian day. And we are going to convert this into the date. And finally, we are using Julian day. SP means spell out. And we are getting like this.
More like typecasting. You are using today.
Pardon?
It's more like we are doing typecasting of salary into date.
Exactly. We are going to convert the salary into the date. And we are going to convert the date into the character. Okay. Now, the next is, so these are the date functions we are having. Now, the next we are having a general function. Some general function is there. Like I am going to use select user from dual. Yeah, we are getting the name of the user. Suppose I am going to use select greatest of this one. We are going to get the greatest value. We are going to put the, I want to get the list value from dual. We are getting the smallest value. So greatest is the function, list is the function. As such, number of parameter is not fixed over there. You can put n number of values. Suppose I am going to use select ename comma job comma decode. We are having the function called decode. Decode function is there. This is just like the if function, like if. So I'm just going to write decode of job. If the person having the job called salesman, I want to display like good job. The person having the job called analyst, I want to display like better option. Otherwise, I want to display enjoy from EMP. Yeah. The person having the job called clerk, we are writing enjoy, no job. The person having the job called salesman, we are getting good job. The person having the job analyst, better option. Otherwise, for the president, for the, so this is what we can use the decode function, just like the if statement. If job is equal to salesman, display good job. If else if job is equal to analyst, display better option. Else display enjoy not. So decode function we can use like if. If job is equal to salesman, display good job. Else if job is equal to analyst, display this one. Else display this one. So we can use the decode function like this. So this is the decode function. The same thing we can do by the use of case also. We are having the also the case statement. I am writing case job. When salesman, then I would like to display good job. When analyst, analyst, then I want to display better option. Else I want to display no job. And I'm just going to use and from EMP. Yeah. So we can also apply the case statement. We can also apply the case statement. We can also apply the decode. Case job, when salesman, then good job. When analyst, then better option. Else, no job. And this is the end of this case from EMP. So this is how we can apply the case statement. Remember, this is the interview question. What is the difference between decode and case? Remember, decode is a function. Case is a statement. Because, remember, case is a statement. So, case is always faster. Case is always faster in compared to function. So, if we are having the option called decode and case, I will go for the case because case is the statement. See, in the case we are not using any parenthesis and all, but in decode we are using the parenthesis because it's a function. So, this is the interview question you need to remember. What is the difference between case and decode? So, decode is a function, case is a statement. And case is always faster in compared to function. And so case is always faster because it's a statement. Remember, the second thing, we can't use decode function in PLSQL. This is again the difference. You can use the case statement within the PLSQL. But you cannot use the decode function within the PLSQL. So this is the important questions for your interview that you need to remember. Clear? So these are the normal functions, like how to apply the decode, how to apply the case, so how to apply the date function, how to apply the string function, how to apply the numeric functions. So these are the different functions that we need to remember. The important question was how to display the salary in the words. The important question is what is dual. The important question is how to drop the table, like how to drop the dual table. The important question is like what is the difference between decode and case. Other than that, these are the functions that you need to apply to display the date, to display the time, how to display the time. We can use the two care of sys date and all. So this is the thing that we need to remember regarding the function. It's clear?